everybody. Welcome to Video LP. I'm Madeline Woods, and today we're coming at you live from L.A. In observation of our Black History Month, Video LP is saluting a man whose career spanned over half a century. He created music that ranged from the classical sketches of Spain to his own hip-hop-oriented doo-bop album for the 90s. It's Miles Dewey Davis, the man with the horn, who was also an accomplished painter. We're going to tell you a whole lot more about him later in the show. I have a guy joining me that recorded with Miles Davis on his last album before he died. It's rapper Easy Mo B giving us the 411 on what it was like to work with Miles Davis. Plus later we've got a man who played bass with Miles. He goes simply by the name of Foley. And he'll be talking with us also about his experiences with the legend. So stick around. We'll be right back after this. Video LP live from L.A. We're back on Video LP saluting Black History Month today, and our focus is the late Miles Davis. Well, my next guest played with Miles for the last 6 years of his life. He had a special relationship with him that he's going to tell you about. He plays bass and has a new album about to hit on the Mo Jazz label, but he goes by the name of Foley, simply Foley. Welcome to Video LP.
Hi, how you doing?
I'm Define. How are you doing?
Okay.
Now, obviously, you're a pretty uninhibited, daring kind of guy.
Now, little.
When you hooked up with Miles Davis, you went a back route. You actually passed your tape off first to Marcus Miller, and then he transferred it to Miles. How come right. You didn't go straight to the source yourself?
I didn't know the source.
Really?
At the time. I really didn't even know Marcus.
Mm-hmm.
A friend of ours was modeling with Ebony.
Mm-hmm.
And she had known Marcus, and we were playing on the phone one day, calling up all these people that she had met. You know?
Oh, no.
And I had it three-way, so I had these people's number
mm-hmm.
for like a year or so. And I just decided to call one day, and he was home, and he told me to send him a tape.
Mm-hmm.
And I did, and he got it, and he called back, said it was happening, and, you know, I'll call you back. And he never called back, but Miles called back like 2 weeks later.
Wow.
And asked me, did I want to play?
Mm-hmm.
And told me to send the tape that I sent Marcus.
To him, to
yeah.
Miles. What's really funny was that when you hooked up with Miles, he actually fired somebody out of his band to bring you on.
I don't know how that story went. I think
that's how I heard it.
The guy that was there, Miles loved Hendrix.
Uh-huh.
You know, and I was probably a little closer to that thing.
Mm.
I didn't mind playing really loud.
Mm-hmm.
And he liked loud sometimes.
But what was interesting, I think, the way the story was that he actually fired his guitarist.
Mm-hmm.
And you play bass.
Lead bass.
Lead bass.
Yeah, it sounds just like a guitar. People think I'm playing guitar.
Uh-huh.
Like, it's four strings, and I just try to create the illusion of a guitar.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah. On your debut album, you have three songs actually dedicated to Miles Davis.
Yeah.
The Senate and September 28, 1991
mm-hmm.
and Little Davis. Let's talk about each one, starting with The Senate.
Senate, actually, that's the reason I called the album 7 years ago, because that happened 7 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
I was goofing around in the studio, you know,
mm-hmm.
And I came up with this thing, you know, thinking that he would dig it,
right.
Not ever knowing I would meet the man, and he ended up hearing it. You know, so I just talked about everything that happened in that last 7 years of my
mm-hmm.
life that I've seen and heard, you know.
And September 28th?
That was the day he died.
Yeah.
And my mother came in and told me that he was dead, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I was just playing along, and I ignored it, you know what I mean, trying mm-hmm. to deal with it. But I went back and listened to that tape like 5 months later, and I just thought I should share that,
mm-hmm.
you know.
When you first heard that Miles died, how did it affect you?
I ignored it, you know.
Through?
That's the best thing I could do at that time
mm-hmm.
to deal with it. You know, I just kept practicing, you know.
Mm-hmm. So you were in a state of denial, right?
Yeah, a lot. And what's weird is those were the chords that came out.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
How long did you know him?
That whole time,
yeah.
5.5 years, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so in that time you really bonded with him, and
yeah, yeah.
It was really hard for you to deal with that.
Yeah, it was different. Mm-hmm. I learned more probably off stage from someone like that
mm-hmm.
of higher thinking and intelligence, you know.
Yeah.
More so than the music. That was gonna happen naturally if I was gonna continue to grow, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But just the stuff off stage, you know.
And Little Davis.
Yeah, it's just a story he was telling me about when he was like 15 and
that's
he wanted to go on
song.
The road, you know,
mm-hmm.
and his mom wouldn't let him, and he was, you know, upset, and he stopped off to the room, and I was thinking of these melodies he might have been playing,
mm-hmm.
and he liked that song a lot.
So you mentioned that when you worked with Miles that he really helped you grow as a musician. What
yeah.
was it that he did for you? What kind of advice did he give to you?
Well, his advice was to just, you know, stay honest, you know,
mm-hmm.
and do your thing, you know. He didn't like you to practice unless it was on stage.
Really?
Yeah, he wanted to keep that energy.
And make it just
that
impromptu.
Yeah. Because you can rehearse anything to get old
right.
real quick.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, you might not even like it no more.
And you become complacent with
yeah.
it.
Yeah, so and just he can hear that. You know, he could hear it. If he heard that, you were out.
So he kept everything new and fresh and
all the time.
Whatever goes.
All the time. He loved yeah. the edge.
That's incredible. We got to go now to video. 22 Metal, VLP.